Hello, I am Rosjke Hasseldine. I've been working with mothers and daughters as a therapist and coach for 30, well, about 30 years. I am the founder and director of Mother Daughter Coaching International, where we teach online courses for mothers and daughters and professional training on mother-daughter attachment for mental health professionals and coaches. I'm the author of two books, The Silent Female Scream and The Mother-Daughter Puzzle, and our website, and there's a lot of free resources on there, articles, videos, is motherdaughtercoach.com, motherdaughtercoach.com. I want to talk to you about the uncomfortable truth, I can use that term, that essential mother-daughter attachment training or mother-daughter relationship training is missing from mental health training or curriculums and courses and coaching courses. So our counselors, psychotherapists, social workers, psychologists, coaches, life coaches are not being trained to understand the dynamics, the underlying dynamics between mothers and daughters. As far as I know, I'm the Mother Daughter Coaching International is the only one that offers this training. When I talk to women, I asked a friend the other day, she told me she was seeing a therapist, and I said to her, "And has your therapist received mother-daughter relationship or attachment training?" And she didn't know. She had just assumed that all counselors and psychologists and psychotherapists, social workers, life coaches would have this essential training because she knew, she already knew, and she was not a trained therapist or coach. She knew that her relationship was vital. Her relationship with her mother was vital to understanding who she is, which is exactly what the women's development research, Carol Gilligan, Jean Baker Miller, to name a few, there's many more, have found that our relationship with our mother is vital to understanding who we are. So she was shocked and actually angry. And I get that because actually so am I. I have been knocking on training organizations' doors for about 20 years now, and most of them have stayed shut. I either don't get a response to my many email inquiries, or you get fobbed off with, "Well, we'll call you," and they, of course, never do. What we are, as therapists and coaches, taught is the attachment model. And though Bowlby's attachment and Mary Ainsworth's attachment model is accurate, there is a massive piece missing in there, and it's also inaccurate in the way it sets mothers and daughters up for conflict by the way that mothers are seen as the primary and only and best caregiver. There is sexism there. So some of the theories that we're taught are often created by men, and in this case, it was an upper-class man in England in the 1940s. So the theories were taught see women through that lens, through a 1940s male upper class English man's eyes. So where is women's reality? Where are the theories and the tools, like the mother-daughter attachment model, that really help get behind women's eyes and look at women's reality? We really need to look at why this is missing. Because the mother-daughter, the underlying understanding the attachment dynamics between mothers and daughters is vital to understanding how we are, who we are as women, women's emotional development throughout their entire life, systemic sexism, understanding and healing generational trauma, facilitating emotional empowerment and generational change. Challenging patriarchy. I think there's a clue in terms of the internalized sexism that and the unrecognized internalized sexism that's within the mental health profession and the coaching profession. And as I also say, that mothers and daughters are 50%, over 50% of the population. So what I'm saying here is that at least 50% of the population is not being covered in the training. Their developmental need, the key essential information for 50% of the population is not being covered. What does that say? That women, again, are being marginalized, that women are not being covered or seen through a male lens. And that's how women are being covered, through the male lens. That needs to stop. And what is this causing? Increased conflict, increased misunderstanding, mothers and daughters not being helped by therapists in the way that they deserve, and the increased estrangement between mothers and daughters. Very questionable and actually toxic so-called diagnostic labels being used, like mother wound, mother hunger, toxic mother, narcissistic mother. And women's history, which is what, mother-daughter attachment model says, one of the three parts of it is that mother-daughter relationship is a history lesson. So the history of women is again being silenced. And it's not just what's happened in women's lives. It's the emotional reality that women live in and the generational themes that are being passed down. So I want to encourage women when they go and see a mental health professional or a coach, ask them, have they had mother-daughter attachment training? We need to put more pressure on because this information is essential to understanding women. Thank you for listening. If you need more information about our courses, and again, there's a lot of resources, free resources on our website, visit motherdaughtercoach.com.